My name is Tom Welland and I'm 18 years old. I'm 40-4 in the amateurs and I'm about to embark on the biggest journey of my life. I'm moving halfway across the world to become boxing's first ever Filipino Olympic gold medalist. This time it's got to be a different level of focus. This time I'm going in blind, I don't know what I've got in front of me. I want the Asian Games gold, I want the Olympic gold medal. It's all a dream unless you work. Philippines have never had an Olympic gold medal.
He could knock you out clean.
I'll rip your body to pieces.
If you're serious about sport, then it ends with the Olympics.
On paper, they'll say I've got no chance, but I know I can do it. I'll never ever crumble under pressure. That pressure will make me.
He will make an exceptional professional and go all the way.
This is my fight. I'm next in line. In boxing, you don't put your all into it, you are going to get hurt, you're going to get knocked out, you might have a broken rib or a broken jaw or a broken nose. There's so many different things that could go wrong if you don't put your all into it, and people don't understand that. Can't waste this opportunity. And if I don't do what I'm doing now, if I go out there and something goes wrong, I'll look back in 6 weeks and think, I should have been prepared before I left. I can't afford to be in that situation. I need to be confident going out there that I've covered everything that I need to do. I've trained as hard as I possibly can for that 3 weeks, hit the ground running and improve myself properly when I get there.
He was invited to the World Youth Selection from the information that I'd received, not just from Tom, but from a couple of the coaches there. He did really well. So his hopes were kind of pinning on being selected. As it was, he wasn't and was given relative feedback into his reasons. And us as coaches, we absorbed that in feedback, and it affected him deeply because he genuinely felt that he excelled and did everything that he had to do.
I need to cover every style before I go to the Philippines. I don't know what I'm going to see. They could put anyone in front of me and I need to be prepared for it.
You've been hit several times already.
I do think he's been overlooked by England, if I'm honest. If he can confidently go to Wales, fight the Welsh champion who got a Commonwealth Games bronze medal, and confidently beat him, why is that the first time he's fought for England? Why has he not been looked at closer at in the past?
When one door closes, another door opens. So you either dwell on it or you hatch a plan. So our reassurance was finding out that he lacked international experience. That's our forte as a club.
Sab sat down with him and said, right, we've got a plan, this is what we're going
to
do.
My amateur coach, Sab Leo, he said to me, look, we'll go and get the best amateur international experience you can get.
It was quite an ambitious plan, and Thomas and I sat there and we said, look, if you manage to achieve that, that's really something quite special. Honestly, if it wasn't for Sab, he would not be in the position that he's in.
I had 10 fights in 10 weeks in 3 different countries, all internationally. I won a national title on the way, the King of the Ring in Sweden, I got best youth in Denmark.
And Denmark boxed twice, boxed an exceptional Danish champion, in which he won, and then boxed a multi-title champion, winner of many belts. Tom won that one as well, so first gold medal in Denmark, which, you know, he was extremely ecstatic and overwhelmed by. I'd say the acid test was King of the Ring in Sweden, which attracts between 400 and 500 boxers. Tom boxed 3 times, and again was exceptional in all 3 contests.
One of the 3 fights, the first one, on that lad's Instagram, it was full of videos of him knocking kids out. Thomas knocked him out cold.
I knew then that I was starting to get to that stage where I could knock people out.
The transition from youth to senior overnight was apparent.
And then England then came knocking for me to box against Wales.
He had to boil down to 55 kilos for this one, always competing at 57. It was kind of a statement for Tom that I'm here, I feel like I could have been picked. And by all accounts, he was superb.
But I went to Cardiff, which was his hometown, boxing for England against Wales. I beat him unanimously.
International meeting Cardiff by a unanimous decision in the blue corner.
How are we?
Here we go again.
Started my boxing career at West Ham as an amateur as well. I won my first couple of titles, and at the time it was the club to be at. A lot of competition at West Ham. Everyone wanted to be top dog. Eat or be, survive or sink. And if you sank, then they chucked you out. It was quite simple. It was, you hurt someone, you went in to finish them off. We were essentially the toughest out there.
Get in there first, Thomas. Good shot, go on. Keep going. Go on, Thomas.
15 my first pro contract was offered, which obviously is very early, and I would have been stupid to take that because I'd been boxing not even 2 years, maybe 2.5, 3 years at a push. I mean, the signs were there early.
He's always, from a young age, when he started boxing, he's always been a fighter. And I think that comes from his size, because he's a bit smaller than the others. So he didn't really have the physical attributes to sort of box and move, because he didn't have long arms like the others did. So he's always had that style of going in there and having a bit of a tear up.
I'm not the usual English style of boxing. I don't have that. The English style of boxing is very much stand up tall, bounce on your toes and score points. I'm not like that at all. That's not me. I'm the complete opposite. I'm very much a walk someone down, cut the ring off and hurt you. And that comes from my West Ham days.
You're not allowed to break. Oh, look at your hairline.
Me and Jim Jar, we've been sparring for about 3 years. Like week in, week out. I can know each other very well.
And it's Vizioli!
When he gets in close with you on the ropes, he lands his shots, and you've got to be careful of getting knocked out, pretty much. That much power for his age would knock you out clean.
It's intense. There's quality in both these rings at the same time.
Stay toe-to-toe with him, you will get hurt. Tom's always twitching. You've always got to be focused. I remember last week, first round, he caught me on the ropes with an overhand shot. Yeah, I wasn't ready for that, and it woke me up, and I got back to boxing. But yeah, you know, you've got to be very sharp with Tom.
Makes for good spar, because you have to adapt to each other. He knows what I'm doing. I've got to set it up more. I know that he's very technical, he's very skilled. If you give him that range, you'll pick it to pieces. But we both know each other inside out, so it's a hard spar, but it's a good spar to watch as well.
Down to the Philippines to represent them as a country couldn't have come at a better time for me.
If you're serious about your sport, then it ends with the Olympics.
I wasn't getting many opportunities out of England, and they were overlooking me. The Filipinos didn't. They gave me the opportunity.
He was determined to sort of follow the path of potential Olympic qualification, which led to Tom's involvement with Philippines through Brady.
Both Olympians from the Philippine Olympic squad, Carlo Palan and Yumi Martial, both silver and bronze medalists at the Olympics 2020. They were liking my stuff, following my journey, because they know I'm half Filipino. All I wanted was a training camp, like a 6-week training camp. Gave Yumi a message, like, got straight back to me. It was like a Christmas present. I was just shocked. I sent over fights, star fights. I said, oh, it'd be fantastic for you to join.
I don't think he'll look back now, I think, regretting anything that he has said post-haste regarding being selected for England. Now he can overlook now and say, well, I'm in a better place.
You know, I think he should have been selected, but it's not my decision, that's their decision. So what he's done is he's taken that and used it as motivation and turned it round so that now he's the one that's in a position where he could be going to qualify for the Olympics.
It's been a journey for him, and he's worked so hard what he's got. I know that he's gonna be fulfilling what he wants to do. The sadness is I won't be there to see it, because we're always there for him. We always watch what he's doing. All of the fights that he has done, I was there, I'm always there for him. We're always there for him, supporting him. As a mom, it's mixed emotions, to be honest. I'm so thrilled for him and excited for him. And the other side is, I will be missing him. I will miss him. And he's such a good son for us. I can't ask anymore. It will take time for me to just accept that, no, it's not here now.
Even though I don't run at a good pace, and even though I don't run for long, it doesn't take me long to feel jelly in my legs and then for me to have to push through that stage. Ultimately, that's what we need to feel when we run. Because if I get caught over the top of the head and I feel that jelly in my leg, I know that I can push through that.
Tom's just aiming to get round in one piece at the minute. You know what I mean? He's a bit flaky on the mile. He's all right at 400 metres and 800, but on a mile he's a little bit flaky.
I can't run for a biscuit, but I can spar 10 rounds a day, and that's all that matters. Elite boxing is very much like a three-round pro fight. It's very the pace has slowed down a lot more. If you can box that three-round fight at an amateur pace while having pro attributes, you're very much in a good place.
He will take a shot to give fights. You can't go to war with Tom because that's what he does best. If you sit there and think you can go blow for blow with him, long day. For someone that's so small, like 57, powerhouse.
Meds with me, don't just stay in it. Get something going, yeah? Waiting too long. Hack, go on your back.
I'm sparring today. So, I probably didn't need to. If I'm sparring well, in my head, I know I'm mentally prepared.
Training out there is grueling. It's 3 times a day, 6 days a week. Start at 5:30, start whistles blowing. It's nuts, we've got our own chefs. Really a special thing. And I'm happy to do a rib comp to get Tom onto the squad. Every time I think of that, I'm like, it's like a pinch yourself moment, you know?
I grew up in Britain. This is obviously my home. I have a lot of family in the UK, but I've got 2 passports now. I am also a Filipino citizen. I consider myself a dual nationality. I see myself as British and Filipino. I grew up eating what the Filipinos eat, but I've represented England on a level, and it's time to represent the Philippines now.
This little episode now in his journey is, it's going to be exceptional. He's definitely going to come back a different animal.
Thank you, my boy.
That's lovely.
Thanks a lot, mate. Thank you.
Mate, cheers, mate.
Thank you.
Right, who wants to drink?
I've had a drink.
You want to
drink, Bella?
Yeah.
Sure?
She's been having my
lunch. I'll have another. Everything that I've done has led to this moment. Like, this is the start of something special, start of something new. And all the months training and my whole life has led to this bit. So. This is the last little bit. Like, this is my training in England done for a little while. I might not be back in until for another 8 months or so. And you go away as a boy, you come away as a man. Say goodbye to the family, and then the next chapter begins now.
Putting everything into his training and everything into what he's doing, I think he'll get
there. He's got something, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's got something. So we shall see.
I'm leaving everything behind, essentially. I'm leaving my family behind. I'm leaving my coaches behind. I'm leaving my friends behind. Making all them sacrifices, that is my first step to an Olympic gold medal. That is my first step to becoming what I want to become. And I'm going out there to find something new. And sometimes you have to come out of your comfort zone. And again, like I said, there's a lot of pressure on me at the moment. A lot of pressure on my shoulders that I'm carrying, but I thrive under that pressure. That pressure will make me. I've got what it takes, I've just got to prove it.